I gotta tell you, I love the city of Detroit. And as it was pointed out, my career spans 42 years. Young man, 19 years old, joined the Detroit Police Department. But here's my promise to you. The Detroit Police Department is gonna continue to be that lifeline. We're gonna continue to wrap our arms around you because it's that important to me. It's important to me for this city. But let me tell you what I know. The people that persevered in Los Angeles, any idea where they came from? The D, City of Detroit. Because if you can make it here, you can make it anywhere in this country.
Not all superheroes wear capes. Some wear badges and work with students in schools. The newly implemented interactive program has provided safe and nurturing space for girls ages 14 to 19 to express themselves and learn from one another. As sisterhood mentors, we also learn a great deal from our little sisters about their experiences with low self-esteem, bullying, extreme poverty, or even an incarcerated parent. These girls have faced challenges most will never encounter. We believe each deserve a chance at a bright, fulfilling, and productive future.
Today, we acknowledge the women who embody the understanding, patience, compassion, and all the great things about the Detroit Police Department. You women are the best of the best, and today we honor your success, your commitment, and your sacrifice.
We believe that when we have a space that officers feel welcome in, that it projects outward. So we wanted the community to show that we do respect our officers and we do care for them, and in turn, those same officers will go out in the community and return that favor. So they're gonna show care, compassion, and concern because we as leaders are showing them the same. It all begins from the top. We weren't always like this. And I can say that 23 years of doing this job, this leadership from our chief, it expands down. He is a community-oriented leader, which makes the people that he put in place community-oriented. And I think that's why we are so successful at what we do.
Today we will be celebrating the lifetime achievement of four local Detroit icons. Ms. Teola Hunter. Dr. Curtis Irene. Ms. Lily Rosa S. Lester.
The thing I will always cherish is looking into the eyes of the healthcare professionals from this Henry Ford, this great hospital, and knowing how much they appreciate our appreciation for what they do. They're truly our heroes as well. And you know, sometimes it takes a crisis like this to recognize, you know, that we're all in this together. So many times our first responders, like our police and fire, are out there on the front lines, but to recognize our healthcare professionals, that's key.
Hey, we about to beat the police department. I'm going to score 50 touchdowns on them.
Who you represent?
Represent DFD, Detroit Fire.
But last time I checked, we won last year. So I don't know what Captain Dixon and Firefighter Burton talking junk on your video.
Who you represent?
Detroit Police Department all day, every day.
First time in the history of the city of Detroit, we will fly the LGBTQ pride flag. We are a community committed to inclusiveness, where everyone matters and everyone can contribute. I appointed Officer Danny Woods, DPD's first LGBTQ liaison to the community. We're proud of the work she has done and the connections she has made.
Hey, what's up? It's Big Greg from Hot 107.5. Posted up right now down here at Shane Park for the Youth Summer Jams. Shout out to the DPD for coming down here and showing the youth what it's all about, man. Of course, shout out to the Stillman Foundation and Hot 107.5, man. Salute all DPD. What up, though?
We have approximately 1,100 youth between the ages of 14 and 17, and they work majority in senior citizen buildings. They run errands and escorts and provide companionship for senior citizens. Well, it bridges the gap between senior citizens, and we are part of the Mayor's Detroit Grow Detroit Young Talent Program.
And it basically changed your whole meaning of like police word and just in all, because some people just think that whole police word is just all wrong. You know what I mean? It's just showing you how to be a leader, how to grow up in life and make better responsibilities for yourself.
I learned organization throughout the summer. I also learned how to communicate with others more properly and to be around people that I have never met. And it was cool.
Working a lot of long hours, so my girlfriend helped me out. We collectively, myself and my partner, put in the money and bought 30 turkeys and ourselves, and we're gonna distribute as many as we possibly can throughout the day today.
Freak, Danny!
Man! I know you said you're getting ready, so I hope this helps you out.
Other SVU people back here. Their goal is really to make children feel safe. And sometimes a teddy bear or a unicorn or some type of stuffed animal can help a child feel safe, whether they're investigating a crime or they're just doing the community outreach that they do because they are so dedicated to children in Detroit. A stuffed animal can help bridge that relationship.
Just the brainchild of WWJ and the Detroit Police Department coming together, deciding what we can do to help not only families in need, but the families that help the Detroit Police Department and actually help WWJ. We are so happy that we have the opportunity to be able to do this.
Detroit Police Department believes so much in the Sergeant Santa program. We know the positive impact it has on many in our community.
Thank you, Santa. You guys, thank you. God bless you. Can I get some hugs? Thank God for you guys.
Please come in.
He's gonna wake up so happy. Now my babies have a Christmas. Thank you so much. Thank you.
this is something that is warms your heart deep inside, seeing the look on these kids' faces when they get something that they want. It's overwhelming.
Chief Craig, and we got a whole crew bringing toys and gifts and all that great stuff.
But they got two boxes full of them. They have
oh, thank you so much.
Moo.
Yes, I see. I'm just so glad and very thankful that everybody could come together and make my family happy.
Merry Christmas!
We're here at the beautiful Ford Field and working with RISE, the Michigan State Police, Detroit Police, and some of our local youth. I am just ecstatic over this opportunity. You know, we do a lot of this in Detroit anyway. Any opportunity to take it to the next level is always good. This group of young people certainly are interested in what we have to say. They were very attentive. And so I think this is going to be a good day for them and be a good day for us. It's an opportunity to really bridge that gap and continue our effort to build trust in our community. So, Detroit, thank you.